starting today, people returning by land borders will also need to show proof of a negative PCR test taken within 72 hours before arrival. And all returning travelers must quarantine for 14 days after coming home or risk heavy fines and possible jail time. These are some of the strongest measures in the world. But with new variants emerging, we're stepping them up even further. Later today, Ministers Haidu, Blair, and LeBlanc will announce the details of new testing, quarantine, and enforcement for everyone flying or driving back to Canada. These measures will take effect starting February 22nd. Putting these additional measures in place is a true team effort. To Canadian Airlines and border agents, thank you. To public health employees, to hotel workers and owners, thank you for all the work you're doing and for doing your part. The initial quarantine, the initial testing on arrival needs to be a PCR test. Everyone who arrives everyone who arrives in Canada has a test, a PCR test, over the past 72 hours. So we know that even if they start to develop the virus inside of them, it'll still be at reasonably low numbers, which is why a rapid test on arrival is not as good as a PCR test. That PCR test, particularly if there are significant numbers of travelers, could take 2 or 3 days to get a result. As soon as they get the result of that PCR test, they will be free to go home and quarantine themselves. It's not a punitive measure to keep people in quarantine for 3 days while they get the result. It's just so that we can get a negative result off of that test. Now, anyone who shows up at a border crossing without an adequate quarantine plan already is directed to quarantine facilities approved by PHAC so that they can do it safely. Many people will choose to do it because particularly in cases of new variants that are much more transmissible, it becomes extremely difficult to quarantine in a home and not pass this new variant to anyone else in the home because it is much more transmissible. So every decision we're taking is based on the best possible evidence and will continue to be as we do everything we can to protect Canadians from the threats of these new variants.